table here.
Wait, what do you think, what are the most important use flags? I saw a flag PIC. Is that the position independent code?
Yeah, position independent code. Yeah, it's in the beginning. I think I have a bad habit of keeping the list on each use flag, even if it's on by default. So you don't need these long lists to have a working Gentoo system. But I think position independent executables are on by default. I'm not completely sure, but I think it's on.
But do you can force it if you spell it out here? Like, can there be any packages which opt out of it?
There might be some, but I think nowadays it's a general policy to keep it enabled. So. Yeah, I may return to the slides after showing the main conf and move on. So, how we build the system, when we are issuing the command to install something and doing an emerge, it has several stages it'll go through while the package gets installed. The first stage is fetching the source files, which is configured in your package file. And then it unpacks, do some preparations. This is the time when it applies some patches, issuing configure. Normal configure we'll call the GNU configuration system, but it has of course support for CMake and other compiling options for. And then when the package gets configured, it'll compile according to the configuration, and when it's ready, it'll install. But when installing, it'll only install in a separate directory, not on the system. And only at the last stage, which is called QMerge, it'll move the whole package onto the system. And in the meantime, it'll make a list of all files it installed on the system. I may show you, for example, here, I'm entering the package database I have in. These packages are installed on the system. For example, I'm just GNOME system log, it's installed. And these files are created when you installed your compiled package. And you have several files here showing what use flags were used to compile it, what were the compiler flags, and what features were enabled, but there's also a file called contents. So if I'm opening it, you will see that you will have all files installed, listed in this with a hash, and also it also knows the length of the file. So this is a very easy to read text-based package database system you can browse. I think it's one of the strengths of Gentoo. If I want to show you, for example, an installation, let's install something. I don't know, have you ever used Gentoo before? Because
a long time ago. But.
Uh-huh. So example, okay. This local means that I created it. Or is it in sysadmin? So all these are packages I modified a little bit. Rotate.
Where did you modify them?
There are some, for example, I'm just
would Neon be a good example?
Yeah, I'm trying to show you an example. This one is the GR Security Administration tool, and I usually introduce a small modification for that. Because it has restrictions on the directories you can issue important comments, security comments, and I'm altering these directories which can only be made at compile time. So I just added a small patch to the e-build, which will do some very minor modifications, which is important for me later on. So I'm just, this is a small program. I thought that I'm showing this to you because it doesn't take a long time to compile. So first, you can unpack, source unpacked. If you go to Warper TMP, you will see, so this is the temporary directory var TMP portage. You see that a sysapps directory has been created where we have our package, and in this compilation directory we have the vert directory where the source code is stored, and we also have a temporary directory, for example, where we have the build log. We already have the build log here, which only says that we unpack the source. And if we go to the vert directory, we see the whole source code is located here. So it unpacks the source. I'm sorry. If we move on, we can prepare the package. You see that by preparing it applied two patches, and this one is what I introduced here in the air build, gradmin root, so I did some directory modifications. And after we prepared it, we are about to configure it. It doesn't need any specific configuration and compile. While we are compiling, we can see that it uses the C flags we defined in the make.conf file, and when it's compiled and we install, it says that completed installing, and it installs in a separate directory, an image directory, where all the files which are meant to move to the system are stored. So if I enter here, I will see here an image directory where it installs all files, like for example in sbin it'll about to install the gradmin utility. So, and if I would issue qmerge, this install would get moved to the actual system, and all files which have been installed would be recorded in the var db pkg directory I showed you before. So contents recorded and all stuff would be written there. So you can keep a track of all the packages installed, and you can do modifications at any stage. I'm using here the abuild command, which you can use to go step by step. But if you are using the emerge command, it will automatically do all these steps for you. So if I'm saying emerge gradmin, it will do all this stuff automatically for you, and you don't need to do it step by step.
What was in the emerge file of this package?
Let me show. So
if we,
it's not a complicated e-build. So the package files for the e-build files. First of all, there's a header of the file, and this API means the version of the e-build system it relies on. And these stuff which are listed here, these are features of the e-build system we are relying on to. So for example, the flag-o-matic means that we can alter the flags with this module. Toolchain functions means that we can do some toolchain alterations and stuff. So let's move on. Here we see a slot null. Slot means that there can be some multi-slot packages, so there are multiple versions can be installed at the same time. And here we also can see that there's only a single use flag available for this package, which is spam. Then it lists the depending packages, so it depends on Bison, Flex, and this statement says that if we specify the PAM use flag, it also requires virtual PAM package. Virtual PAM will refer